Care of the classic.
The best. Okay, factoring trinomials. So we talked about factoring trinomials when our a value was a number that was equal to 1. In other words, 1. In this case, we're going to look at when a is another number or a number other than 1. Okay. So in this case, we have 3. So the first set of factoring, actually, I shouldn't have said that. But a is, well, I've said it, is 3. What's our b in this case? 14, positive 14. And what's our c? 8. Good. This is very important for what we're about to do. The first step we're going to do is we're going to see if we're able to common factor out. If we can common factor, then we might be able to use that very simple method we knew before where we find two numbers that add to b and two numbers that multiply to c. And if we can common factor out so that a is 1, we can use that method. Can I find a common factor of these values? No. So now we have to use a different process. This process will work even when a is the number 1. It's just a little more in-depth. It's a bit longer for you to go through this. So the first method I'm going to show you today, Ian has now named synthesis. I like it. So we're going to name it that. Okay? In order to do this, we need to find the factors of our first term, our a. So what are factors of 3? 1 and 3. That's it. Factors of 3 are 1 and 3. So I'm going to put a little box around this, and I want it to be red, and I just realized I can't tell what red is. Oh, this is way faster. Watch. See? Okay. Next thing we're going to do are factors of 8. What are factors of 8? 8 1, 2 and 4. Perfect. And same idea. We want to set these up in columns. I think that's green. We set up our columns. The reason I've set this up this way is because what we're going to do is multiply one of the columns from the first number, which is this column, obviously, it's the only one, by one of the columns of our C value. The products, so the product is when we multiply something, the products are going to add up to our B. Okay? So we're going to add up the products, and they're going to equal positive 14. So, by trial and error, we're going to try this out. I'm going to find what is 3 times 8 and 1 times 1. Okay. Is there any combination of 24 and 1 that equal 14?
No.
No. So we've gone directly across. We also have to test diagonally. So 3 times 1 and 1 times 8. What does that give us? 8 and 3. Any combination of those make 14? No. So this first column doesn't work. Okay. So we can eliminate it. This doesn't work. What does work, Neil? 3 times 4 and 1 times 2. 1 times 2 gives us 2. 3 times 4 gives us 12. Perfect. And when we add them together, we get 14. Excellent. So what we've just discovered, okay, is this is going to be our first column. And this will be our second column. That will show up in the notes. So in our factored form, we have two sets of brackets. Okay? The numbers in the first term are going to be the first terms in each of the brackets. So in this case, we had 3 and 1. Well, we're going to just add an x to it, so it's going to be 3x and 1x, or x. Now, this is the part that's important. Because I multiplied 3 times positive 4, okay, they have to go in opposite brackets. So the 3x and the positive 4 has to go into the other bracket. And our other number 1, which is our x, and positive 2, they have to go in opposite brackets when we put them in. So we have positive 2 in the other bracket. And the reason for this is because if I were to FOIL, remember this is factored form now, if I was to FOIL to go back to standard form, I need to make sure that I'm multiplying the 3 times the 4. So they have to be in opposite brackets in order to be multiplied by each other. So that's the reasoning behind it. We did do this a great day. So essentially our answer, I'm just going to write it all in black here. 3x plus 2 and x plus 4. Okay, so we're going to do the same question. We're going to do decomposition, though. In decomposition, I've rewritten this. We need to find two values that multiply to a times c. That's why I've written it this way. Okay? And those same two values need to add up to our b in this case. So when we go to write that out, that means we need two numbers that equal, what is 3 times 8? 4. And those same two numbers got to add up to what is our B value?
14.
So we need two numbers that multiply to 24, and the same two add to 14. So we can just kind of go through factors of 24. 1 and 24, do they add up to 14? 2 and 12, do they add up to 14? Boom, perfect. Okay, that worked. And if you guys recall, those were the two products we used over here. So there's similarities between these two. So we're looking at the numbers 2 and 12. So what we're going to do now is we're going to rewrite the original equation, and we're going to decompose. In other words, we're going to even expand this even farther than it is. So what I'm saying is, what's going to happen is we're going to take the value of 14 and we're going to split it into two values. Okay? We'll still have 3x squared, but 14 will now become 2x, and again it's positive, plus 12x. Because 2x and 12x do add up to 14. So it's essentially the exact same equation, I've just written it a little differently. And then we have our plus 8. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to common factor the first two numbers and common factor second two numbers. On your notes, it shows up fine. I know on this screen it's not looking good. Those are 12 and 8. Okay? I'll write them on the slide. So I need to common factor. What is a common factor of 3x squared and 2x? Just x, right? When I factor x out, what's left in the brackets? Great. And I need a common factor of 12x and 8. 4. So we factor out 4, what would be left? 3x plus 2. Sorry, I wrote an extra x there. Good. So now what I want you to notice is this is very similar to our common factoring. These brackets are identical, and that's what needs to happen in this case. We need to get identical brackets. I can common factor out those identical brackets. The two brackets, when we common factor them out, we're left with 3x plus 2. And what goes in our other bracket? That's right, the x and the 4. We have x plus 4, which is identical. Can we see it all on one page? Sure we can. There you go. It's identical to our original answer. 3x plus 2 times x plus 4, 3x plus 2, x plus 4. So exact same thing, just two different